This is a story of a true American badass who lived between 1848 and died in 1914. And during that time, a young lad named Felix Ward became a true American legend. He started off in a really strange way. He was adopted by a rancher named John Ward, who had a cattle ranch in southern Arizona. And during a trip, while his father was selling that cattle, an Apache group raided that ranch. And not only did they steal the cattle, they also abducted young Felix Ward. John Ward came back and was furious and demanded that the army take recourse on the Apaches that had done that. A gentleman named Bascom became an intimate player in this series of strange events. Bascom was a young army officer who was put in charge of making sure that young Felix Ward made it home alive. Bascom got a hold of Cochise and brought him into their encampment and demanded the boy be released. Cochise, who was innocent, claimed his innocence and told him that if he gave him 10 days, he would find the boy. Bascom decided that that was not going to work and tried to abduct Cochise. Cochise famously escaped, and that started the war that would be the longest running war in the United States, 25 years. Now, one of the curious things about the abduction of Felix Ward was that young Felix was missing one eye. And the funny thing about that was one of his captors also was missing an eye. And that might have been the reason that this boy of 12, which would normally be way too old for Apaches to abduct, they would have just killed him. But they brought him in. Now, eventually, he was traded to the White Mountain Apaches. Young Felix joined the U.S. Army Apache Scouts on December 2nd, 1872. In just a couple short years, he became a sergeant. He was posted to Camp Verde as an interpreter, and that's where he met the legendary Al Seaver. You know, most of the soldiers couldn't pronounce the Indian names, and so he got a nickname because of his red hair, freckles. He bore a strange resemblance to a character in Charles Lever's 1840 novel, Charles O'Malley, the Irish dragoon named Mickey Free. And from there on, the legend named Mickey Free was born. Free served as a scout for George Crook in pursuit of Geronimo, along with others. He also accompanied Geronimo to Washington, D.C. in 1886. He left the scouts in 1893, but it was also known that he hunted the Apache Kid. The Apache Kid at that time had a price on his head of $15,000, and he became a legend. After leaving the Army, Free moved to the Apache Indian Reservation in the White Mountains and lived out the rest of his life as a farmer. He died on that farm and was buried there. During that time, he married four times, had two sons and two daughters. Mickey Free will live in infamy as another American Southwest badass. Black Flag Expeditions, Chiricahua.